hopefully implied to you that there are other ways to multiply. There are probably an infinite number of ways to multiply two numbers together, okay? Two and three and four digit numbers. But we do it a certain way because it's easy, convenient, and fast. But it also, it does not make clear what we're really doing, okay? How we're really counting up all this stuff. Also, why we multiply fractions the way we do, the way we multiply fractions. Okay. There's a way that we multiply fractions, and it gets the right answer and everything, that's great, but we probably don't know why. We may not even remember how. Maybe a little rusty for you. We'll see. That's what we're looking at today. Okay. We're going to use area to understand both. Okay. Ready? Here we go. All right, so we found the area of all these, I assume. How about the area of this little guy right here?
12.
12 what?
Squares.
Okay, this one?
150.
150.
Squares.
Which, how do you do 3 times 50 in your head?
3
times
0.
3 times 5.
And then.
No, 3 times 5 is 15, and then you add the 0.
Okay, that's how I do it in my head. It's not the right way or the wrong way, right? But just 3 times 0, 3 times 5, certainly that would work as well. I do 3 times 5, 315, and then put the 0 on there, 150. How about, I forgot to fix that. Okay, now it's a 4. What's the area of that?
160.
Okay, you get some interesting math in your head there. How do we do 4 times 40 real quickly? 16
and
0.
4 times 4 plus 0.
Add a 0 on there, okay? How about 40 by 50 rectangle?
2,000.
No, I meant
like
2,000, right? You got, it's really like this. You can look at it this way. 40 times 50 is 4 times 10, right? That's 40. Times 5 times 10, because that's 50. We can just do 4 times 5 times 10 times 10. 10 times 10 is what?
100.
And 4 times 5 is that many hundreds. 4 times 5 is 20. We have 20 hundreds. So we have 2,000. So good? You get what we're doing there? We're finding the areas of those four rectangles. Okay. Now we had, I think, in this class, time enough to. But I gave you 3 multiplication problems on the left, 3 areas on the right.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay. Let me go ahead and just drop that from. Can you find the area of this rectangle? Oh, the answer is yes. Yes, you can find the area of the rectangle.
Okay. What are we supposed to say?
Do you have it already, the area of this rectangle here?
Oh, yeah, we did it.
Yeah.
Oh, you did it. Okay,
yeah,
so you already did the work, and so it is what?
54 and
2,322.
2,322 squares. Okay, square units, and a square. What if we were to add up all the areas of all of these rectangles? Anybody just do that for no reason? No? Okay, let's do it now. Let's add them all up.
It'd be
1,000, 3,000. Does it look familiar?
Yeah.
It's the area of the rectangle that's 54 by 43. What do we get if we move this here and this to there? Sure, 2,322 squares, what are the dimensions of it?
This side is
fifty-four by forty-three. So we have a rectangle that's 54 by 43. If we multiply 54 by 43, we get the area of the rectangle, right? If we find the areas of all of these smaller rectangles, we find the area of the big rectangle when we add them all together. And when you do something like 54 times 43, you do all of these things, you may not realize it. Okay, let's look at 54 times 43. 54 times 43. Let's look at what we do first. Normally when we multiply two things together, two-digit numbers, we take 3 times 4. We get 12. So that's what we did here. This little rectangle is 3 by 4. Now what do the 3 and the 4 have in common, say, is different from 50 and 40? We have 3 of and 4 of here.
Squares?
You don't have squares yet, not until we multiply. Then there's 3 along here, there's 4 along here. Let's say that there's 3 of them here, 4 of them here, there's 5 here. What's their 5 up here? 5 of 50?
Mm-hmm.
There's only 1 of 50. There's 5 of what?
Tens.
You see what we're doing? We're dividing this rectangle along the place values. Right? I measure along here until I get to 50, and I cut off that rectangle there. I measure along here until I get to 40,
right?
And I just separate off the 1s. I get the 1s here and the 1s down here. Okay? This rectangle is a 1s by 1s square. What do you get when you multiply a 1 by a 1?
1.
So when I say 3 times 4 is 12, I'm saying it's 12 ones. Right? That's what we're doing when we do 3 times 4. So why do I put a 1 there? Why do I carry that 1? I'm counting up all the 1s. Why do I put a 1 right there?
I can't?
Okay, because the way we write our numbers, the Arabic numeral system, we've been using the Arabic numeral system our whole life, it's the way we break it up into ones, tens, hundreds, and so on. The way that works is if I have some tens, I tell you how many tens I have. I don't tell you that I have 12 ones. I move over to the tens place and say I have 2 ones and 1 10. Okay? So that's why the 1 comes over there, but could I just say that I got 12? 3 times 4 is 12?
No.
Let's find out. Okay? Well, let's do it the normal way, I guess. We'll put the 1 there. Then what do you do? 3 times 5, right?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. You're supposed to suspect. Is that 3 times 5, really? 3 times 5?
Plus 1.
Plus 1.
Okay, plus 1, but is it really 3 times 5?
Yeah.
Is it even really plus 1?
Yeah.
Let's look at the picture here. We did the 3 times 4, now we're doing the 3 times 5? Is it 5?
Yeah.
This is 5?
No, it's 50.
It's 50. It's not 3 times 5, it's 3 times 50. Or if it's 3 times 5, it's 3 times 5 what? What are the 5 of? You just said? 5 tenths. So when we do 3 times 5, and we get 15, finding 15 of something. What do we have 15 of? Not ones.
Tens.
We've got the tens. 15 tens. You said it yourself when I asked you how do you multiply 3 by 50 really quickly? How do you multiply 3 by 50 really quickly?
3 times 5 and add 0.
3 times 5 and add 0. Because when I say 3 times 5, I think it's 15. I'm saying I have 15 what? 15 ones?
Tens.
Tens, 15 tens. 15 tens is 150. So this 3 times 5 is 3 times 5 tens. So when I get 15 and add one more and get 16, what do I have 16 of?
16 tens.
16 tens. So when I put 16 there, I'm saying I have 16 tens. tens, and like I just put that 16 down, and there's a zero there, I'm really saying 160, right? And there's the two ones that I had from before.
Mm-hmm.
Right? 160 plus two more.
And then
we move on to 4 times 4. Is that 4 times 4?
Yeah.
No, it's
40 times 4. 40 times 4. Which we see right there. 40 times 4. Finding the area of the big rectangle, we break it into small rectangles. Exactly what we're doing here. 3 times 4. 3 times 5. 4 times 4, we get 16. 16 what? 16 tens. When I put a 16 right there, we're putting a 0 there, right?
Yeah.
And nothing goes there. I'm just saying I don't get any 1s. Of course you don't get any 1s when you multiply 1s by 10s. If I just have a bunch of groups of 10, I'm not going to have any 1s. I'm going to have 0 in the 1s place. Okay, 160. The only problem is we don't really put a 16 down there, do we? What do we do with this 1?
Carry
it. And put it here. Because next we do 4 times 5. Is it really 4 times 5?
4 times.
4 tens and 5?
5
This 5 right here? Is tens, right? It's in the tens place. 5 tens, 4 ones. 4 tens times 5 tens. 4 tens times 5 tens. What do you get when you multiply tens by tens? 100. So now we're getting, when we do 4 times 5, we're really counting out how many hundreds we have. 4 times 5 is what?
20.
20. We just found that we have 20 what?
20 hundreds.
20 hundreds.
To add a zero.
Okay.
Which would be 2,000.
20. But we have this 1 left over from before because we counted some tens earlier. We got so many tens that we got 100, right? So many tens that we brought over to the 100 place. So 4 times 5 is 20. 20 hundreds plus another 100 is 21 hundredths. 21 hundredths. Okay. Two zeros for hundredths. We add them all together. 2,322. Whether we view it as 54 times 43, or the area of a 54 by 43 rectangle, or the sum of four rectangles. One of them is a 4 by 3. 4 by 3. One of them is 3 by 5 tens, 3 by 5 tens. The other one is 4 by 4 tens, 4 by 4 tens, 4 by 4 tens. And the last giant one here, as we count hundreds, 4 tens times 5 tens. Do that again. Real quickly, 3 times 4 is 12, which is 12 down there. That's how many squares are in this rectangle, right?
Yes.
3 by 4, that's how many squares are in this rectangle.
Yes.
And then if I go 3 times 50, understand that's 3 times 50, what do I get?
150.
150. 150. I'm just telling you how many squares I'm finding in every group. Okay. How about 4 times 40?
160
squares or whatever we're counting up. And 5 times 4, 50 times 40.
2,000.
2,000. 2,000. 2,000. And again, just different approach, you get 2,222.
Why is there 3 twos?
Oh, okay.
Because it was left over from over here.
Okay.
3 twos.
So the purpose here is to show you why we break it down the way that we do. I'm not going to show you a bunch of other multiplication methods, but there are lots. Many, many civilizations throughout time have used many, many different multiplication methods. Okay? Some of them use place value. Some of them use, I'm just counting up 54, 43. We talked about how multiplying 54 times 43 is counting how many you have if you have 54 43s, right? 54 43s, I said, imagine you had 54 bags, right? And every bag is what?
43.
43 things. Give me anything.
Apples
or people or horses or anything.
People.
54 bags and every bag is 43 of something?
Bags.
And 54 43s, how many are there? That's kind of a hard problem if you don't have this method or a good established method. If I have 54 bags and every bag has 43, it's kind of kinda hard to catch, to count them all up.
Okay. It's a really tricky problem. We've come up with a really cool algorithm that we've used for
a lot of years. Longer than probably anybody you know has been alive, right? We've used this algorithm. But after all so many years of it being taught over and over and over and over, we forget that what we're doing in this case, we're counting up all of the squares. How many squares do you have when you have 54? Okay, so now I'm counting like how many columns of 43. I could put 43 squares here and 43 here, 43 here, 43 here, and I could stack up 54 of those 43s and then get all of these squares. Right? How do we efficiently count them up? We found a really nice way to count them up. First of all, we put numbers into groups of ones and tens and hundreds and thousands and ten thousands and hundred thousands, right? And then we break it into little problems. I'll do 4 times 3, I'll count the ones. I'll do 3 times 5 and count the tens. And I'll do 4 times 40, I'll count some more tens. And then I'll do tens times tens and count all the hundreds. It's a really neat thing that we do, but it can also be a little too magical, a little too mysterious. Now the nice thing about seeing multiplication as area is gonna do two things for us today and a little later. There we go. It's gonna help us see today why we multiply fractions the way that we do. That's, I think, one of the most mysterious multiplications that there is. When I learned fraction multiplication, I was so relieved after learning fraction addition. So much easier than fraction addition. Fraction addition, you have to find, what is that you have to find when you add two fractions?
Common
denominator, and then you're trying to find the least common denominator, so there's this number that can be multiplied to by both of these numbers, but it doesn't necessarily have to be one number times the other, and it's a real hassle. Then we got to fraction multiplication, it was so easy, but that even made less sense as to why that works. So we're gonna see it today with this area law. And then, there's this thing called the distributive property. I think you guys have heard of the distributive property before. And this guy right here does a really great job of explaining why. Why do we distribute? At 5 times 3 plus 5, why is it the same as 5 times 3 plus 5 times 5? But for now, let's talk about fraction multiplication. So if I, real quick, if I do this multiplication of all, or the area finding of all of these. And this is obviously a 9 by 5 rectangle there. If I do 9 times 5, and 5 times 20, and 30 times 9, and 30 times 20, I find the area of all those separate rectangles and I add them up. What have I really found? What times
area
what?
Of one big.
One big rectangle, that's how big? On either side.
29 by 35.
Yeah, the perpendicular side here. And again, one last time, this, breaking this into 4 rectangles, is exactly what you do when you do the multiplication algorithm that you do every time you multiply something by hand, every time you don't pull out a calculator. Okay. That's a nice little picture of that. Now, let's jump into this fraction multiplication problem. I wonder how many of you remember how to do something like 4/7 times 3/8. 4/7 times 3/8.
Yeah.
You just multiply them together and simplify if possible.
Yeah.
Pause on that one. See a lot of good stuff out there. Looks like a good percentage of you remember how to multiply 2 fractions together. Okay. Before I just say, here's the answer, let's prove to ourselves why that would have to be the right answer. Okay. Here's what we have to do first. We have to know what fractions are telling us. We have I write a number and a line and a number under that number. What does it mean? Okay. Everybody want to take a crack at what 6/11 means? Cool.
6 divided by 11?
Okay, 6 divided by 11, that is true. The answer to the division problem, 6 divided by 11 is 6 electrons.
Okay.
Okay, like whatever decimal I would come out with, the fraction would be 6 11ths. So as a number, as like the answer to that question, 6 divided by 11, that's what I want to think about it. That it's a number that's less than 1. Right? So what exactly does it all mean, 6 11ths? Anybody else have another explanation?
Part of a whole.
Part of a whole?
Yeah.
Okay, we're getting there. It's a number that's smaller than 1. It's part of it. Okay, so it must somehow tell you how much of a whole you have, right? How does it tell you that? How does it tell you that? How does it tell you how much of a whole you have? Okay, so 11 is the whole. What do you mean by that? 11 is the whole.
11 is how much there is. 11 is the entirety of the pie.
Okay, so like 11.
11 would be the entire. It would be how many pieces of the pie.
Okay, so I got these pieces of a certain size, and if I add 11 of those pieces, the whole thing.
Yeah.
That's what I would have. If I had 11 of a pizza, and I put 11 of those pieces together, I'd get a whole pizza. Right. So we can say this is how. How many make the whole thing? Whole pizza, whole dollar, whole pencil, someone suggested last class. A piece of paper, whole plot of land, okay, whole paycheck. Right? And take up these pieces, blend them together, make one thing. I like to say, we could say it a little bit differently, a little bit shorter, the size of the pieces. Does that make sense too? So the size of the pieces in a way? Right? How big are they? They're big in such a way that if I put 11 together, I get the whole thing. Okay? They're this size. 11 make one. 11 make one whole thing. All right, so 11 is how many you would need to make the whole. So it gives you a sense of how big these pieces are. And 6, what does 6 tell you? What's that? I'm going to think of it less as like a division problem more than a number that's less than 1. The way I'm telling you how big this number is, 11 of these pieces would make a whole. What would 6 represent?
6 pieces from
11? 6 pieces from the 11 pieces, right? So, see how many you have. And how many pieces you have, and this is how big your pieces are. It's not enough to just say 6. How big are these pieces? They can be huge, they can be small. Right? So that's why we have this number here. It tells us how big the pieces are. How many pieces make one whole thing? Could someone come up here and just kind of draw on this line in such a way that shows us what 6 elevenths looks like? Cole?
No,
half,
I'm good.
Half of a hand is anything there? Hunter, you're going to show us what the 6 elevenths looks like?
On a line?
Yeah, just like cut the line up so that we see 6 elevenths. Okay, show it, like show us more detail, like show us all of the, show us 11. Like just cut it into 11 pieces. Show us what that would look like. You know, do your best. Okay, so is that 11? Did you do it right? You gonna cut it into 11 pieces?
Yeah.
Okay, got a couple of confirmations. All right, so that's 11. That's the 11th part, because it takes 11 to make what? 11 to make 11? The whole thing, the whole line in this case, okay?
Yeah.
All right, now show us 6 elevenths. Is that 6 elevenths?
Yeah.
Okay, 6 elevenths of what?
I was counting.
have to show that there are 11 pieces that make the one thing, and you show that you have 6 of those 11 pieces.
Alright.
So now on the next screen, we're going to show you how we can see this matrix, this fraction multiplication in the picture. I'm going to do that, I'm going to show you a square that's 1 by 1. We're going to see what part of the square we have. So first let's see our two fractions. There's 4/5. Let me show you 4/5. So I'm showing you 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pieces in the whole, and we'll look at 4 of those 5 pieces. And here are 3/8. Half and half and half again. Down to 8. Now I have to show you 3 of those. There's 3, and now we're looking at 3/8. What shape do we have here?
Square.
Square. How long is this side?
4/5.
Keep in mind I had gone all the way out to
4.
Here.
5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5. 6. 5
five
squares.
Hashes dashes.
Do those represent?
Five pieces.
Five pieces, how big are these pieces?
Square.
There's one, two, three, four, five fifths. Five fifths. What do five fifths altogether make?
Bless you.
The whole thing. In this case, the whole line. From there to there is one, right? One. I'll put a one down here. And how long is this side? From here to there?
One.
One as well. One by one.
Okay.
Now remember, we're talking about, like, one is kind of the standard. We're talking about fractions as being less than one. Okay, so if I was measuring this out, it'd be like 1 foot by 1 foot. Okay? So what's the area of this rectangle here? What's the area of it? What's that?
One.
Right? Area is how many squares fit? How many squares is this? It's a 1 by 1 square. It's 1 square. Talking about fractions, we're looking at smaller than one, so the whole thing is one. One square unit. That's the area of this square, is one square. Alright? So far so good? Thumbs up? What's that?
I have a permit to leave the building note again. I don't know who it's for, I can't read the name.
Oh. For a person. The area of the whole square is 1 square, and the area of this, the area of this little rectangle here, that's 3/8 on one side and 4/5 on the other, should be whatever 3/8 times 4/5 is, right? How many times have we found the area of something by taking the base times the height?
Quite a bit.
Quite a bit, even just this year. Not counting the rest of your life, it's already a lot, okay? So the area of this should be whatever 4/5 times 3/8 is. The thing that's tricky about it, though, is we're measuring the area. The area of the whole thing is one. Right? So the area of this is smaller than one. It's pieces of one. If I just count these, well, it doesn't really work because are these squares? No, they're not squares. We're trying to figure out how many squares. And actually, we're trying to figure out how much of a piece of a square we have. One square is the whole yellow thing. less than one, it's a piece of one, it's a piece of the square. How much of a piece of the square is it? Well, there's two parts to it, two pieces of information. One is, how many pieces make up the whole thing? Remember, the whole thing is the 1 by 1 square. How many pieces make up the whole square? How many pieces make up all of this? If we cut it in 5 pieces this way and 8 pieces this way, how many pieces make up the whole thing? When I cut it 5 pieces this way and 8 this way, I wind up with 40 of these. Here, I'll just show you what cutting that looks like. We cut it 5 ways this way vertically, we cut it 8 ways horizontally. How many pieces is it in?
40.
40 pieces. We've cut the whole thing into 40 little pieces. So that's our denominator. That's how many pieces make up the whole thing. That's how small these pieces are. So take 40 of them to make one square. Right. What did this represent? This represented how many pieces it takes to make the whole. What did the numerator represent? We talked about 6, 11. So 11 was how many it took to make the whole. And what does 6 represent?
How many you have.
How many you have. It's written right there.
Yeah.
How many you have. So, if we have a bunch of these things, 40 of them make one whole thing, how many do we have in here?
12.
We have 12 of those. Yes, we can simplify that. We'll talk about it in a second. But we're just trying to figure out those two things. How many pieces make up the whole thing? 40 of them. How many of those 40 things do we have? 12 of them. How did you figure out that it takes 40 pieces to make up this one square?
8 times 5. 5 times 8.
8 times 5, right? 5 pieces this way, 8 pieces that way, 40 pieces all together. Okay? If we're looking at this multiplication problem, to figure out how many pieces make the whole, it takes 5 pieces to make this whole by 8 pieces to make this whole, so it must take 40 pieces to make this new whole. We can think of it as a square. It's 40 pieces to make up this whole thing. And how many do we have set aside in this little rectangle? We have 12. How'd you figure that out so quickly?
4 times 3.
4 times 3. 4 times 3. Straight across, there it is. Okay. This thing is cut into 5 pieces. This one's cut into 8 pieces. Right? So if I think about it as an area, this new square thing is made of 40 pieces. How many do we have? Well, we had 4 going this way. By 3 going this way. So we have 4 times 3, 12 of those pieces. We can simplify it, we can divide both of these by 4, and we can get
3 tenths.
But this picture shows us why we multiply straight across. When I learned matrix fraction multiplication, they told me just multiply straight across. No idea why. And when we come along and we have things like 4x plus 10 over 2 times x minus 5 over 6, trying to multiply those two things together, having a firm grasp of not only how do we multiply fractions, but why? It'll make this a whole lot easier. Because here's what happens a lot when I have students that I'm trying to teach this to. Okay, we're supposed to multiply these. We now know and have proven that you multiply straight across. Okay, so we multiply straight across. But this student is trying to multiply this thing by this thing, cross multiply. Okay? They're getting confused because there is a thing called cross multiplying, but this isn't the time to use it. So they're getting confused about that, and they're cross-multiplying there, and they're getting this wrong answer. And not only can they not do this problem, they don't even understand like the basic fraction multiplication. So we have to go all the way back and talk about how to multiply fractions. Now, if you start today, and if you
getting confused about should I multiply straight across or am I supposed to cross multiply or whatever, when you can think, no, I know I have to multiply straight across because I can think of this picture briefly, okay, then that's not a problem here. I don't have that hurdle. I don't have to back all the way up to this thing because I never remembered it correctly and then build all the way back up in like 1 day or 2 days back up to something like this. So we multiply, we'll multiply straight across because all we're doing is counting how many pieces it takes to make the whole thing and how many of those pieces we have. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Do this for me. Back up to the one we had before. Okay. 4/7 × 3/8. Real quickly, draw this same kind of picture to show us what the product of 4/7 × 3/8 is.
It's 3/10.
What's that? Sevenths times 3/8. We had a rectangle that was 4/7 × 3/8. We multiply the, we found the area of that, we'd have the product of 4/7 × 3/8. To do that, build a square. That's a 1 by 1 square. Should look like, but it's not perfect. 3/8 × 4/7, right? 3/8 × 4/7. This is a 1 by 1 square. So this big square here, one way we cut it into 7 pieces, the other way we cut it into 8 pieces. So how many pieces make up the whole square?
56.
56. 8 × 7. 56. And how many pieces do we have in this little rectangle?
12.
Right? 4 × 3. That's how many pieces we have of these little pieces. Right? These little pieces that are this size. 56 of them make a one whole. You can simplify this. You can divide both of them by
4.
4.
You get 3.
14.
Because it took another minute, we could see that we can group some of these pieces together in such a way that we have 3 pieces here, and it would only take 14 to